Hello everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft. This is video design team member Jeshri this side. Today I am sharing a process tutorial on how to make a mixed media layout using handmade Fomiran flowers. But before we get started, please do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Today for my layout, I am using Dress My Craft's one of the first pattern papers, Dots and Stripes. I have chosen two different colors and designs for my layout. I have adhered the vintage color stripe paper on a chipboard for my base. I have also distressed all four sides of the paper before adhering. Now for layering, I am tearing off the purple dots pattern paper in a random manner to fit in the center as well as on the top right corner of my base paper. Again, I am distressing the edges of these papers to sync with my base paper edges. Using double-sided foam tape to adhere these papers to give a little dimension. Once done adhering, I'm going to apply a coat of clear gesso to seal my paper. This will prevent from water to be absorbed by the paper. I'm using here a silicone brush to apply my gesso as I want to leave behind some textured marks in the background for some interest. Once the gesso dries, I'm using weaving stencil and distressed block stencil from Dress My Craft to add some textured design in the background. Textured design, I'm using distress oxide ink pads in the color Broken China and Worn Lipstick. I'm just smooshing out some ink on my craft mat from Dress My Craft, spraying some water to it and then applying it to my paper. I'm going to dry this layer of paint and then repeat the same process with the other color. Achieved the desired color and the paint has dried, I am starting to build my composition. I have here fussy cut elements from hydrangea lawns and dots and stripes motif sheets, a resin frame and tons of handmade Fomiran flowers made using 4 petal pointed die set and curved flower die set from Dress My Craft. I have used foliage and leaf die set number 5. For layering, I am using distressed medical gouache and classic doily die cutout. Please do give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying watching this tutorial. Also, you can find the list of supplies used from Dress My Craft in the description box below, so do check that out. have adhered, I am mixing some art stones along with flower pearls in black color from Dress My Craft in some gel medium and applying it around my resin frame and other floral elements. Adhering some sequins in the color Pink Celebration here and there for more interest. Lastly, I'm topping up my layout with a sentiment tile from Dress My Craft. Here, our layout is ready in no time. I hope you enjoyed this process tutorial and are inspired to make your own using Dress My Craft's beautiful papers and cutting dies. Please don't forget to subscribe to the channel before you go and give this video a thumbs up. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye-bye.